Welcome to FluidSIM video tutorials. This video describes troubleshooting in electrical engineering. These are the topics. Overview of failure models in electrical engineering. Failure models in didactic material. Definition of electrical faults. Failure simulation, repair mode. Failure simulation. Use of virtual measuring devices. Failure simulation, parameterizable failures. Overview of failure models in electrical engineering. FluidSIM 6 contains failure models for selected assemblies. Failure models are available for wires and cables, voltage sources and potentials, manual switches, relay, hazard flasher relay, lamp, dual filament lamp, resistance, and potentiometer. This allows circuits with defective assemblies or lines to be simulated. With virtual measuring devices, failures in electrical circuits can be localized and corrected in repair mode. Failure models in didactic material. The electrical engineering didactics material is opened via the menu ribbon, Didactics. In addition to the electrical engineering learning program, the automotive engineering teaching material is also available. Troubleshooting and diagnostics are the focus of the activities of the automotive mechatronics technician. The teaching material introduces the basic circuits of electrical engineering and the use of real and virtual measuring devices. The troubleshooting tasks at the end of each topic consolidate knowledge and apply it in a practical way. The first task for troubleshooting the rear fog light explains the work steps and tools for troubleshooting. The simulation mode can be switched on within the teaching material, and the failures can be simulated. The description of the malfunction is displayed above the circuit diagram, and the failure status is signaled by the yellow or green color of the title bar. Line animations and the display of state variables are suppressed after activation of a faulty circuit. With virtual measuring devices for current and voltage, the circuit can be measured during the simulation like with a multimeter. In this way, the failures are narrowed down to one or a few assemblies. In the repair mode, all failure variants are displayed for each assembly. The analysis of the possible failures determines the selection of the probable failures. If the failure is found and selected, the simulated circuit works correctly. Definition of electrical faults. Failures are defined in expert mode in the ribbon, simulation, with the command, manage failure configuration. With the button, new, a new failure configuration can be created. In the failure configuration dialog, the title and a description are first specified. Both are displayed during the simulation in a yellow title bar above the circuit. The components in which a failure is to be installed can be selected from the list of non-defective components. It is recommended to label all components and lines. If you check the box, also list objects without a label, all objects in the list are displayed. Without labeling, it may be difficult to find the desired component in the list. If the component is selected, it appears on the right in the defective components list. The desired failure model is selected in the drop-down box of the failure model column. Some fault models can be set in the parameters column, for example to a faulty voltage, power or resistance value. Now the functionality of the repair mode has to be set. How should the repair success and an incorrect diagnosis be displayed? What repair options are there? Should the line animation be suppressed? With OK, the failure configuration is confirmed. Additional failure configurations can now be created in the management dialog for failure configurations. The order of the failures in the configuration can be changed with the arrows on the right. In addition, failure-free simulation and circuit processing can be inhibited. The failure configuration that is displayed first after loading the circuit in the menu ribbon, Simulation, is selected in the drop-down field, Default Failure Configuration. Finally, the failure configuration can be protected with a password. Failure Simulation, Repair Mode. Failures with increasing degrees of difficulty were defined for the parallel connection. In the menu ribbon, Simulation, the desired failure model is selected in the drop-down field. If the failure-free simulation is allowed, learners can simulate the correct function of a circuit. In the example, both lamps light up as soon as switch SF1 is actuated. In edit mode, failure 1 is selected and the simulation started. The yellow title bar indicates that there is at least one failure in the circuit. The lamps light up regardless of the switch position. The failure can also be found without measuring devices. If the Activate Repair Mode button is pressed, the mouse pointer changes to a wrench in the circuit. If the mouse pointer is over a component, the wrench is displayed in a circle. When you click, possible failures in the respective component are displayed. The switch in the example is probably short-circuited. The correctness of the assumption is permanently indicated with a green tick according to the settings in the failure configuration, and the circuit works correctly. The status is also signaled by the green title bar. Failure simulation. Use of virtual measuring instruments. Failure 2 is selected and the simulation started. If the switch, SF1, is actuated, only the lamp PF1 lights up. A virtual measuring instrument can be selected in the simulation ribbon. The crosshairs on the mouse pointer is the position of the display of the measured value, which is defined with a mouse click. Then the measuring tips can be placed in the circuit. As soon as the measuring tips are placed, the measured value is displayed. If you click on the measured value display, you can set the properties of the measuring instrument, such as effective voltage. With current measuring instruments, the current path is automatically separated and the measuring instrument is connected in series. In the example, there can only be a defect in the lamp itself. The first possibility, blown filament, is the most common cause for circuits already in service. Failure simulation, parameterizable failures. Failure 3 is selected and the simulation started. The lamp PF2 only lights up weakly. The voltage at lamp PF1 is 24 volts and at lamp PF2 is 12.8 volts. The currents through the lamps are also different. If you measure the voltage on lamp PF2, compared to the ground connection of lamp PF1, 24 volts are displayed. The line connection from lamp PF2 to the ground point must therefore have an increased line resistance. In the list of suspected defects, only one faulty resistance value can be selected. Once the correct failure is marked, the circuit works correctly. In the fault configuration, the W6 line was set to a resistance of 100 ohms. The operating voltage of 24 volts is therefore divided between the internal resistance of the lamp and the cable. The current through the current path also decreases due to the summation of the resistances in the cable and lamp. The lamp lights up weakly or not at all. Errors that can be parameterized are very practical, since errors often occur slowly during operation due to wear, corrosion or other causes. Thank you for your attention.